Hello guys, welcome back to Let's Play Xanadu for the MSX. Now in the last part, we picked up the final weapon from the level 10 tower, which is of course the famous Dragon Slayer sword, which is what the series is named after. As we found out, our Dragon Slayer sword is actually not useful against regular enemies, but is only useful against the final boss. It's not strong enough to attack normal creatures, having a strength pretty pathetic, 5700, compared to I don't know exactly how much, but much more for the Whirlpool weapon. Let's see, yeah, almost 900,000, so clearly a big difference. So we will be using the Whirlpool weapon against regular enemies, and our Dragon Slayer only for fighting the final boss. Now it might be the game's intention that you pick up a bunch of these magic gloves to increase your experience with the Dragon Slayer sword. I'm not sure if that's necessary. So I'm just gonna try and make a straight run for the King Dragon and see how far we get. If it turns out we can't damage him, then maybe we need to go hunting for some leftover gloves in towers or from monsters or that sort of thing. But actually, come to think of it, it might have been a good idea to leave a bunch of monsters back in level 2 or 3 or so, just so you can use it to train your Dragon Slayer sword on them. But it's a little late for that now, so let's see if we can fight ourselves a final boss dragon thing. As soon as this guy gets out of the way. Here we go. Back into the tower. And since we've cleared out most of the tower already, it shouldn't take too much time to get there. I will of course need a lamp first. And I will also equip a mirror so we can get there a little bit more quickly. I'll pick up this glove with the Dragon Slayer. Don't think we can damage these guys, can we? No, we can't. See, so the Dragon Slayer, there's really no way to level it up by killing normal monsters. It's just too weak. I know there's at least one more glove in this tower, so I'll definitely pick that one up. But I think that's going to have to be it for experience for us. Leave these guys. I think it's straight ahead here, isn't it? I think so. Yeah, that's the one I'm looking for. Pick up these keys, we've got plenty, but whatever. So yeah, maybe over 100 keys was a little bit overkill, but since I've got stuck in this game so many times by not having enough keys, I'd rather err on the side of caution. Do we go down from here or to the right? I think it's to the right, isn't it? Yep, it is. Right, and then down. Okay, I think we're almost there. So this is it. We will start attacking the King Dragon and seeing if this, if we did right or wrong. And let's see, is there any item we can use? I guess red potions. Hopefully it'll be enough. You know what? I might have been able to pick up another level too. Oh well. Let's see how far we get. Wow. Oh yeah, of course, you can't use items in this fight. Okay, so. Wow. Clearly this is not a good strategy. Let's try one more time, see if we can hit him from above or from behind or something. But I don't really think so, to be honest. Okay, we can hit him from above, but we still die instantly. Be perfectly honest, I'm not sure what we're doing wrong. I guess we need more defense.
Yeah,
You know what? I think I will actually go back to level 1 in that case, pick up some mantles, see if I can find the plus 7 large shield instead of the plus 7 small shield we're using right now. And I guess maybe use the monsters in level 10 to gain more experience with the shield as well. I guess that's what we need to do. I'm pretty sure we can still gain a lot more experience on the battle suit as well if we find a monster that can hit us without us, you know, dying instantly to it. And there might still be some creatures in the lower levels I skipped that can help us power up our Dragon Slayer as well. I think that's probably going to be our approach here. I didn't actually try my death spell, but I don't think it'd be a little cheesy if we could just use our spell to magic it to death, right? Yeah, see, at 100 a pop, I don't see us making that. Although, to be fair, with a little more experience, we might be able to make it. Oops. Yeah, as soon as he burns us, that's it. So you can't just get close and spam magic at him, clearly. Okay guys, I'm gonna have to think about this one for a little while, so let me think and let me come back and finish this off a little bit later. Thanks for watching, and I will be right back. Okay, we're back. I've been thinking a bit about how to go about this. I think there's a couple of different things we can try. The first being we can go back to level 1, pick up a mantle, and try to find the plus 8 large shield, which is probably a good idea. Not only a good idea, but I'd quite like to see the plus 8 large shield as well, because I don't think I've ever seen it before. And of course, the second option is to pick up some more experience with our Dragon Slayer, and maybe more importantly with our battle suit, because well, I figure if we can take a few more hits from the dragon, maybe we stand a better chance. So that's what I'm going to be doing. I'm going to be going back to level 1, picking up a mantle, which is going to be our primary goal, and along the way I will try to find some more monsters to kill that we missed before, and hopefully build up a little bit more experience with our sword and with our armor. Now, we are back in level 8. Of course, there's still a bunch of monsters in level 10 as well. Oh hey, I missed one of these guys. Come on. We should be able to beat these guys fairly easily now, I'm thinking, hopefully. Yeah, see? Oh, you know what? I'm gonna see if these guys, because they're apparently not gonna be able to hurt us very much. Maybe they can hurt us a bit from behind. Yep, they can. Okay. So I'm going to be using these guys to train our armor a little bit more. Unfortunately, they are not the aggressive type, so it's going to be a little bit slow. But it could be worse. As we were talking about before, it's all about the number of hits. So the more often you get hit, regardless of how much damage it does, the stronger your armor becomes. So this is pretty ideal. These guys are not amazingly strong, but strong enough to damage us. Clearly for fairly small amounts at this stage. So yeah, that's pretty good. The only thing better would be if they were the aggressive type, and they would just hit us constantly. But this is okay. I'm almost tempted to kill them and see if there's another spawn of these guys, just so maybe those are the aggressive types. Check my armor real quick. Yeah, see, we're already over 100, so this is going pretty quickly. I'm just gonna let them damage me until yeah, until my armor becomes too strong for them. I am going to need a red potion in a minute, so let's just go out and equip that. We don't want to accidentally lose another elixir, since we have plenty of red potions anyway. And once we go back to level 1 and we pick up our mantle, we can also just stock up on a few more red potions if necessary. But we're not going to be using a lot of them from here on. At least I don't think so. Hey guys, keep it up. You know what? I think I'm gonna pause recording here for a minute, because this is just gonna take a long time. And it's not going to be very interesting to watch. Actually, let me show you one other thing I'm hopefully going to do, which is equip the Dragon Slayer. If it's strong enough to hurt these guys, it is only barely, but that's good too. Because this way I can also use these guys to level up my Dragon Slayer a bit. And same as with armor, every hit I can land on these guys gives me a little bit of extra experience. We were at 50, we're already at 59, so that's going to go pretty quickly. Just because it takes a lot of hits to kill these guys with the Dragon Slayer. So that makes them ideal for leveling up. This is cheesing a little bit, I know. It's not really, I guess, in the spirit of the game or whatever, but I wasn't really paying attention and saving a lot of monsters for leveling up this sword. I had no idea this was coming, so I think in a real playthrough the idea is to leave a bunch of lower level monsters alive. Oops, I killed one. And just come back later with the Dragon Slayer and pick up some experience. I don't know, sounds like kind of a weird thing, but yeah, Lord Karnov said this on the last video. It's not entirely surprising, these kinds of games have a tendency to just screw you over if you don't do exactly what they expect you to do, even if it's not really predictable. So yeah, I'm just gonna level up these things for a little bit, and I will start recording again once I am done. See you there, guys. Hey guys, just a little halftime report here. As you can see, we've leveled up the Dragon Slayer to 100, and our battle suit to 124 in the meantime. This guy was doing pretty similar damage to the Wyverns I was fighting before, but as you can see, he's almost to the point where he can't really hurt me anymore. I think we might have just broken that point. Oh, here we go. So yeah, he can still sort of damage us a little bit, but not really anymore. So clearly, the effectiveness of leveling with these guys is running out a bit. I'm thinking, unfortunately, I don't think there's any creatures left in level 9 that can... Well, actually, maybe there's still a few Darkstalkers. Yeah, this is pretty much it for this guy. This is not going to be very effective anymore, so let's just kill him. Although I could have milked some more Dragon Slayer experience out of him probably, but yeah, whatever. If 100 isn't going to do it, then I'm not going to waste my time leveling it all the way to 200. Or, honestly, maybe I should have. Although there's probably still some loose monsters running around here somewhere. So yeah, this out of the way. Oops, almost got myself stuck again. You know what? Yeah, we're not going to get any more levels, are we? No. Might as well check though. So yeah, at this point I'm going back to level 1 and going to get our mantle, because that's our next goal. I will meet you there. Welcome back, guys. We are about to leave for the first level, or at least the starting area. I figured I might just use a bottle, because you cannot use a bottle in the outside area. You can't use any items, so I'm thinking maybe if we use it here it might carry over. I don't know, let's see. This is of course because we want to go to the item shop and pick up some yeah. So use your item before you use the portal, just so that because you can't use them out here, as you can see. If I press enter now, it just says what. So you can't use stuff out here. Let's see if time actually moves here. I don't think it does, because we don't lose any food, so I think as long as you use it just before you enter the gate, it should remain active the whole time. So here we go. Like I said, the main thing I want to get is a few mantles. Wow, jeez. I guess a few mantles is out of the question. I guess it's just going to be one mantle. 2.3 million, Jesus. And you know what? Wow, we just barely have enough. Okay, I was hoping to maybe pick up some spare red potions and stuff as well, but I guess that's not gonna happen. Yeah, the These things are way expensive now. No. I just want to see how many of the other stuff I still have. Oh, that was it. Oh, damn it. One more. Yeah. So, yeah, everything else, apparently, we have more than enough. I guess we're running a little bit low on fire crystals, but we're not going to be using those anymore. Oh, I picked up a mantle in one of the towers along the way, so we have one already. And what else? Rubies, bottles, well, we don't need any of those anymore, so yep. I think we'll just use our last bit of gold to buy one last mantle. We have lots of food, so that's not going to be an issue. Yep, I guess we're set. Okay. So, let's get one more mantle, yes. 91 gold pieces left after all that. Okay, let's just show off our armor in town a little bit. Hello guys, remember me? We are badass now. We have a dragon slayer and battle suits and lots of other cool stuff. So I guess that's it. We will be going back to level 9. Or actually, we'll even be going back to level 10 to pick up our, hopefully, our plus 8 large shield. And along the way, I will try to find some more towers and things that have a few more monsters in them, or maybe a few magic gloves or things I left behind. I'm pretty sure there's still a couple of towers in level 4 that we didn't completely clear out, so yeah, I'll check those out and I will meet you back in level 10. Hey guys, back again. So like I said, I went up to level 4 and I found the tower here that wasn't quite cleared out yet, and after going through every single room we actually picked up plenty of experience to go around. So our Dragon Slayer is almost up to 250, our death is 1 point away from maxed, so clearly this was a good choice. Our battle suit is still at 125 because honestly nothing has been able to hit us, of course. But our weaponry at least is up to speed now, so I think we're about ready for another attempt at killing the King Dragon this time. Not really sure. I think if we really wanted to, we could probably try and max out our armor with the leftover monsters in level 10, but I don't know if that's going to be necessary. So let's head straight for level 9 and see if we can finally finish this game. It's level 5, up to level 6. It's a good thing we stocked up on so much food as well, because we burned through about 200,000 food in this short period of time. Pretty impressive, I think. Oh, darn it. I don't think we went down the right way here. Nope, we did not. It's been a while since we've been here, so I kind of forgot which way to go, but I think I remember now. All the way back down here again. And past here. And down this way, I think. Yeah, I think this is it. Here we go. And then up to level 7. There's probably a few more towers that weren't completely cleared out, but apparently we don't need them. Now let me be a little bit careful here, because this is an easy place to get stuck. I think we had to go... Oops. Oh, thank you, Grill. Good thing there's still one of you around. Almost went down the wrong way there. And might as well pick up a little bit more experience with our Dragon Slayer. These guys are not going to be able to hurt us, so Yeah, see? So we won't be able to level our armor on these guys, but that's okay. Only a little bit more experience and that will maybe max out. Close to max out our Dragon Slayer. Wait, where did I have to go? Oh yeah, down and then left. And then this way. And down here and to the left again. And then down, I believe. Yep. And then this one, I think. Yeah, that's right. Okay. On to level 8. I guess we could also... Oh yeah, there's also the tower up here, of course, that we didn't quite finish yet. But again, we've gotten so far ahead now that that doesn't really matter anymore. I would like to get this guy, if I can. Ah. Keeps getting away. Where are you? There we go. Not that we really need him at this point, but you know what, it doesn't really hurt to pick up another elixir. Even though we won't be using them anymore because, as I've been saying, you can't use them in the boss fights, so it's kind of pointless. And in fact, you can't use any items at all for the final fight. Now, I am a little bit worried because... Oops, wrong one. I knew I was getting into the wrong one. I am a little bit worried because, honestly, I don't see how our experience is going to make that big of a difference that we can just straight up kill the End Dragon, the King Dragon. Feels like we need more, but there really isn't any more in the game. Although, oh yeah, I was going to go to level 10 to pick up the large shield as well. You know what, let's try with the small shield first. Should really be enough. Thank you. Here we go. And this will be it. Our next attempt at taking out the King Dragon. Yeah, let's use another mirror. Just to get there more quickly. I wonder. Nope, still not strong enough to kill these guys. So we'll just switch back to the Vorpal for a moment. Hm, 880,000 damage. You know what, even if we can beat the king here... Oops, down. I'm probably going to add on a little bonus section showing you how well we can do against the level 10 critters with our new weapons and armor. And just to show you what the level, or the plus 7 large shield looks like, because I'm kind of curious about that myself. Okay, here we go. I think we're about ready. I don't think these things carry over, but just in case they do. Let's use a couple of things. One more, why not? I think that's all. Yeah. Okay guys, here goes nothing. Time to die, King Dragon. Hopefully. Oops, I forgot to heal up. Oh no, he's gonna insta-kill us. Hey. Ah, yep, there we go. I actually did get a couple of hits in there without getting damaged. Maybe there's a trick to it. Maybe you have to hit him in a certain spot or something. Okay, let's try that again with full health. Oops. Okay, that was clearly not the right way to do it. So what do you think? Do you need to hit the little gray spot on his belly or something? Let's try again. Ah. Okay, so maybe you have to hit him diagonally from below? Oh, you know what? I kind of want to see what our maxed out death spell does as well. Maybe we can weaken him and then just do the last final few hits with our sword or something? Let's see. Wow. Even maxed out the death spell barely does any damage at all. This is not going to cut it. So clearly we have to do something like this. Hey, this is actually working. Wow, we actually got him to halfway. Okay, so maybe that's the way to do it. I wonder. So is it wiser to go up to level 10 and try to max out our armor? Or do I just have to be patient and try a few more times? I'm not sure. Oops. Okay, well that didn't work. I could jump over him, but I'm pretty sure he just turns around. I don't think you can hit these guys from behind. Come on, dragon guy. Oh, oops. Clearly not the way to go. One more try. If it doesn't work this time, I will go up to level 10 and try and up our armor a little bit more and pick up the plus 8 large shield. Okay, that was a complete failure. I don't think the shield is honestly going to make that much difference, and I don't think leveling up the armor is going to make that much difference either. I mean, your defense is 265 and we could probably get it up to 300 or something, maybe 3.5 or 4, but even that's not going to make that big of a difference. Let's just give it one more go. Oops. Strangely, it does seem to do less damage from above, but then if I try to hit it from above... Whoa! Okay. That almost worked. And I don't know why, but it kind of did. Getting closer. Maybe you just need kind of a feel for it, I don't know. It seems to be a little bit arbitrary when he hits you and when he doesn't. Hitting him from below, just hitting him in the kneecap, that seems to be instant death, so you do have to hit him in the air somewhere, but sometimes he kills me when I hit the head, sometimes he kills me when I hit the claws, I don't know. Okay guys, I think I'll just do a little bit of experimenting off screen, because this could take a little bit of time, so let me try a couple more times, and if I figure it out, I will come back. Okay guys, I had a couple more tries off screen, just because it was starting to take a long time. I have something of a strategy, but it's not really very convincing. I still get killed more often than not. I can't really seem to detect any kind of pattern in his attacks, like, I don't know, sometimes he hits me, sometimes he doesn't, I don't really get it. What I have found is that it's probably a good idea to get a couple of hits in, then back off, and then come back and get a couple more hits in. I got pretty close this way last time, but it doesn't seem to be working anymore. I think you have to just be a little bit lucky, to be honest. I'm not really seeing any sort of any sort of pattern or anything. See, this time he didn't hit me, and I have no idea why. Come on, Dragon. Cooperate here. We almost got you this time. There we go, finally. The King Dragon lies dead. And we have earned the title Dragon Slayer. Wow. Wow. That's pretty cool. I can't believe it's finally over. After all this time, we finally beat the King Dragon. Sent him back to where he came from. I like the staff titles for these old games. There's like maybe 10 people who did the whole thing. It's pretty cool. So yeah, I guess I just want to say thanks for watching, everybody. I know there's not too many of you, but it's kind of cool to see that there's at least a few more people in the world that are interested in these old games. I want to thank first and foremost Zenith Moon, who was the first commenter on these videos, I think, and who also kind of inspired me to play through to the end. I was kind of planning to do a few videos about the gameplay, but yeah, he kind of challenged me, and I figured, you know what, why not finally, after all these years, complete the game. I wasn't sure if we were going to make it, but clearly he was right, we can do it. And second of all, of course, I want to thank Lord Karnov, who's been commenting recently, and who helped me get set up so I can try Scenario 2 and a couple of other Xanadu games on the PC88 emulator, which I never was able to get working myself, but thanks to him I have it up and running now. So yeah, maybe I will do a little showcase of the other versions of Xanadu in another video, but I think I need a little bit of a break from Xanadu for the moment. I think I've seen enough of it for some time. But it is very, very cool after all these years to finally finish it and see the ending sequence, even if it's not that impressive. Makes me wonder if the MSX2 end titles are any better than this one. And there you have it. The end of Dragon Slayer 2, Xanadu. Okay guys, once more, thank you all for watching, thanks for commenting, those of you who did, and I guess I will see you in the next Let's Play.